As you know, the Taoiseach is in Berlin today meeting the Chancellor, so fell to me to chair the meeting this morning. In relation to COVID, we agreed as a Cabinet to accept the latest advice from NPHET, and that allows us to take the next steps towards living with COVID as we learn to live with COVID as an endemic virus. Four decisions were made. First was that there will be no vaccine mandates, so NPHET has recommended that we should not have vaccine mandates in Ireland for the general public or for healthcare workers, and that we should continue with our policy of explaining and encouraging people to get vaccinated and get boosted, and that position was reaffirmed today as well. We also agreed that mask mandates will end on the 28th of February, that's next Monday. So as of next Monday, there'll be no legal requirement to wear a mask anymore in any setting, but it will still be advised in public transport and also in healthcare settings for the time being. Of course, there are people who may wish to continue to wear a mask, and they're free to do so. People who have underlying conditions, who are immunocompromised, who are vulnerable, may also wish to choose to do so. And of course, there's no reason why they should not. And also people who perhaps have very mild symptoms or are just recovering from mild symptoms might decide to wear a mask as well. In relation to schools, childcare and early learning settings, the requirement for pods, staggered breaks, masks and physical distancing will also end next Monday. So a more normal school and childcare experience from Monday. However, some measures will remain in place, including recommendations around good hygiene, ventilation, and advice that people should stay home if they're sick, or children rather should stay home if they're sick. There are significant changes being made in relation to testing and close contacts. So at the outset, I should say that for people who have confirmed COVID-19 infection, who have a positive antigen test or a PCR test, the rules stay the same, which is to isolate, to stay in your room for 7 days, and on day 8, 9 and 10 to wear a mask. So that doesn't change. However, the rules are changing for close contacts. So if you're a close contact, there's no longer any requirement to restrict your movements or to isolate as of Monday, unless you have symptoms. So if you're a close contact, unless you have symptoms, there will no longer be a requirement to isolate or restrict your movements as of Monday. You'll only have to isolate if you develop symptoms. One exception is healthcare workers who will be advised to have repeat antigen testing. For people who have symptoms, the rules around testing again are going to change. So testing will be for people who are under 55 and in good health, or over 55, fully boosted and in good health, will no longer be required to have a test. So again, a change in the testing regime from next Monday. People who are under 55 in good health, and people over 55 and boosted in good health will no longer be advised to have a COVID test. COVID tests will be for people who are aged over 55 and older, who are not boosted, people who are pregnant, those with a high-risk medical condition, those who are immunocompromised, those who live in the same household as a person who's immunocompromised, and those who provide care or support for a person they know to be immunocompromised. So very much limiting the testing to those who are sick or immunocompromised or elderly and unvaccinated. Of course, where there's a doctor's referral for any particular reason, that will be provided for. So again, all of those changes coming into place on February 28th and is the next step that we're taking towards living with COVID as an endemic virus, one that we manage in the way that we would have managed viruses like the flu, for example, in the past. There will be a further meeting of the Cabinet Subcommittee on COVID on the 28th of February to consider the next steps beyond that.